I'm Tony Fleming, and this is Fleming's Ultimate Garage.
She's real fine, my 409. She's real fine, my 409, my 409. Well, I save my pennies and I save my dimes.
Everybody, thanks for joining us on today's video, man. This is one of the most iconic super sport convertibles. Forget super sport. Forget muscle car. In general, Impala SS 409 dual four barrel from the factory, convertible with a four speed. Shut your face. Who's buying this car back then? This was an expensive, expensive car. Twice the price of a regular Impala. Twice the price. And keep in mind, like if you were buying a $250,000 house today, would you buy a $500,000 house? No. That's how few of those were sold back in the day. That's why this right here has continued to climb each and every year. It's what we call blue chip investment. I love the fact that you can drive a car and it continues to go up in value. That's the coolest thing in the world. You say, well, Tone, how could you possibly know? How could you possibly know that this is going to go up in value every year? You're right. I don't know that answer, but I do know this. This car was somewhere around $4,000 when it was new. It's no longer $4,000. It's significantly more, and there's the proof right there. Giddy up 409. The Beach Boys even talked about it because this engine makes a sound that is like no other V8 sound that's out there. You can hear it. You can hear the bore and stroke that's in it. When those dual quads open up, it's sucking all the air around you as you're driving. You're trying to shift, but you can't shift. And the reason you can't shift, because there's no air left for you to breathe, because the carburetors need every last cubic centimeter, cubic inch, cubic foot per minute to feed that motor and roll you on down the line. So, anyway, I know that sounds exciting. That's exactly what it is, because we're going to go for a ride in just a little bit, and you're going to say, wow, man, I got to have it. I got to have it. Ship it to me. And that's what I'm going to do. All right, so let's start with this right here. This is kind of cool. This is an original red car. Do you know how many cars are converted to red cars? They call it resale red. Resale red is what the term is called in the business, that a car that's red is easy to resale versus a car that's, say, maybe white or green, you know, all the colors back in the day. You know, we all had like green shag carpet in our parents' house. Ooh. Those cars are a little tougher to sell than red ones, but this car started out as an ember red car. All right, nice paint there. Nicely show waxed and detailed so you can see the letters nice and clear. Make sure if you're looking at another car online, which would surprise me that you're looking at another car outside the safety of the circle of Flemings, but if you were, make this guy show you the video. Get him to bend down on his knees and show you and walk you all around the car. Get the detail before you make that decision. The reason we're able to put a one-year warranty on these cars is because of the quality of the car. We're also able to get almost new car financing now on these cars. No other body can do that for you. You know why? Because these are quality cars and the bank recognizes it, and the fact that the warranty company says so too. Everybody's gotten together and they put together a package, and now you can get a car, a 50 plus year old car that has a 1 year warranty on it, which is unheard of, right? Okay, so we'll walk around and we'll look at some of the super sport things on there and some of the super sport trim, all of the chrome and the grill and the headlight surrounds and the screws and the headlights. T3 headlights here as well. So original style T3 headlights right inside there. All right. And as we walk around, we see the super sport things. All right. Inserts down the side, the tail panel, super sport wheel covers in here. This is just how this car rolled off the showroom floor, man. There's no changes to this car. It's coated that way under the hood. It's restored that way the rest of the way. And it's claimed to be 42,210 original miles. Comes with the original mile title that's been researched by the MVA. They say it's original mileage as well. So if you're looking for something kind of cool to say that, hey, wow, this car's been driven less than 1,000 miles a year, which is pretty impressive when you think about it, because I know, I'm hoping that when you get this car in your garage, you drive it more than 1,000 miles a year. You take another couple out in this car. You take the kids out for a ride in there and they can experience something that they can't get today. We get kids in here now that look at the door panel of a car and they see roll up windows and they go, what are those? Well, you know what they are? They're window cranks, man. What's a window crank? Well, the window crank rolls the window up in it. Where's the button? Where's the heated seats? Where's the airbag light? You know what? That's why you buy this car, because it doesn't have an airbag light. It doesn't have all of the electronic devices and things like that. It takes you back to a more simple time, more like an analog time. You get a nice big tach, you get a big shifter in your hand, and you get power out these giant tailpipes here, and everybody gets to see this because this car was fast, and that's all they ever saw was this great tail panel here, engine turned, with nice matching new bumpers and taillight bezels, all the little stuff that makes it great. The dual antennas, all right, the dual antennas, we put little flags on here just for the victory race, right? These come off, they're just sleeves. But the dual antennas were really just a big piece of the style of that car and really adds to it. Look how nice and straight all of the long body panels are. If you don't do good body work on a car, these long panels here will show you that right away. Here you can see they're nice and straight, they're not wavy, and the car just looks really, really good. All right, so this, although I think this car is a great looking car, this is my favorite part of the entire car. I'll show you why. I also brought a little authentication, all right, authentication, so that we could say, okay, how do we know this is a real Super Sport? Because that really determines the value of the car. How do we know this is a real original coated dual quad car? Because a dual quad car adds a significant value to it, because any of the big block multi-car rated cars right now are going up in value a lot. You want to get in on the trend early, you want to get here, you want to be the guy that had a Shelby Cobra 25 years ago when you could buy it for 50 grand and now it's worth, you know, several million bucks. Don't know that this is that car, but it certainly could because there's so few of them, and having the dual quads and things like that makes it even more rare and rare. So let's check this out for a second. Chevrolet Muscle Car Red Book, all right, in here shows us that the original Super Sports, all right, SS equipment, 63 Impala SS. The convertible would have been a 1867. And so we come up here to the cal tag. And sure enough, here's 1867. All right. The paint code is 922. The paint code for red, all right, is Ember Red 922. All right. Black interior. Bucket seat interior, and that's the key to let you know for sure that this is a real car, because you could only get bucket seats in a Super Sport. This is coded for a black bucket seat interior. Say that a few times real quick. Black bucket seat interior. Okay, so this car is very original, and the reason I bring that up is because some of the things I like about it, some of the things I don't like about it, and that's why that a lot of people say they like the videos, because I don't just sugarcoat it and say, hey, listen, man, this is the greatest car ever built ever. My opinion on this is, and if you come up here for a second, first off, these are the original valve covers. These valve covers are 50 years old. The reason why I know that is, if you look at these little dents right here, these dents weren't put in by a mechanic. They were put in during the process before they were chromed. And that's actually where the inside, the oil drippers, were tack welded onto the valve covers. You can't buy those anymore, all right? They're not available. We have a new set of valve covers on it. I'd like to put them on there, because I think it would make the engine compartment really, really pop and look great. You let me know what you want to do. Regardless, those come with it. Original high-performance manifolds are on here. Check this out, though. These are the original carburetor preheaters for this manifold, okay? This is important. Because there's two carburetors, there's two preheaters. A single one would have had just a single, all right? And we have the QB coded on the block. We have the date code correct in there, all right? We have tower clamps like we're supposed to, all right? We have the correct air cleaner, which is very difficult to get, all right? The incorrect part on this car, okay, that should be changed is this right here. It's a chrome alternator. A chrome alternator does not belong on this car, all right? And this should be a different color as well. So if you said, you know what, I love everything about that car, I want you to fix that and that, then you know what, you'd be right, and that's what I think we should do anyway. So I just throw that out there. Some people won't care. Some people won't care, and I'm not sure I really care, but when I open the hood and go to a car show, I love the fact that this is what it looks like under here. And we're talking about 425 horsepower in 1963. That's a lot of power, man. Corvettes didn't have that kind of power. I mean, trucks didn't have that kind of power. Nothing had that kind of power except this car right here. We would call this the money shot, right? So through the high, through the world of high speed editing, here we go. I unbolted everything real quick. I just wanted you to see those big, beautiful dual quad carburetors feeding that monstrous motor. Look at the size of this engine. That is a lot of motor in there. Set up nicely the way it's supposed to be. Detailed, correct. Wow. All right, so come check this out. Well, you know what? Let me start this over because I want you to hear, because this is a really nice car. I mean, it's like everything just seems to work like it's supposed to. It almost feels like a really original car. All right? So back before you, there were minivans and cube vans and things like that. There were vehicles like this with a nice size trunk. You could either be a baker and carry all your supplies in here. Maybe you were a carpenter or something like that. You put your tools in here, electric tools or air tools or whatever you had in there. Or maybe you were with the mob, dare I say, and you needed to do business back here. And so this, I hear, fits four people comfortably, okay? Or in pieces, you could fit up to eight. So I don't know that to be true or not, but I have read that online. So I don't suggest you find that out, but I was just pointing out that this is a nice size trunk to go away for a weekend, throw some luggage in the back, throw a cooler in the back, go to the drive-in movies with your friends and put them in there and everybody pops back out. Right? You remember those days? That was awesome, awesome, awesome. That's why I love these cars, man, because it takes you back to a different time. The world was a little slower. You had friends a little bit longer, you know. Nobody misread a text message and got upset with you. You actually had to call them and make some fun time and a day with them. And that's exactly what this is designed to do. Slow down, get in the car, and then go fast. All right, come on in here. Come on in here with my smile, all right? Come on in here and see what it's like to take your kids out in a car like this. Another couple out to dinner in a car like this. Can you imagine your dinner experience in a car like this? Look at the dash, man. This engine turn dash, which matches the tail panel of this Super Sport. The original AM radio here. We should hide a digital sound system for you in the glove box like we do for lots of people. Just let us know if you want something like that. All right. The dash, this right here, any of these cars that had over 300 horsepower automatically got the tachometer. So. That's a really nice piece there as well. Lights work, turn signals work, all of these things working like you're supposed to. Bucket seat interior with the console and then this in your hand here. Engine turn dash matching on the console as well. The console and buckets make for a really nice touch in these cars. Bench seat's kind of cool because it's old school, but the buckets make for a significantly better driving and riding experience. That great wheel in your hand. And in this part here, one of my favorite things of all time are vent windows. The fact that these work just like they're supposed to. They let the air in, it flows in. Let's say you decided to take up electronic cigarette smoking. So no chemicals, nothing but steam. But you want to be cool, so you're smoking your steam cigarettes. Huh? Steam cigarettes in your analog car. How cool is that? A digital smoke in an analog car with some Beach Boys coming through your Alpine stereo system that Flemings hid right in that glove box. Let's go for a ride. All right, so we have a little bit of history. This is from, we're doing the video in almost 2018. This is from 2005, showing the mileage and things like that on there. Then we have some pictures of the car during its lifetime. That matches our cal tag that we have. All right, the correct valve covers and all the things that make it a super sport. Some things here that operate and show it to be a real 409 car. All right, this is the oil change. These are receipts and work that we put into the car. Quite a few, many thousands of dollars of that. All right, this is a brochure from 63 for the Impala. It's kind of cool, goes through the iterations of it. All right. And then one important part, and the reason I wanted to bring this up, is it shows the Impala Super Sport interior. You could only get bucket seats with a Super Sport interior. Everything else was all bench seats, okay? That I thought was interesting. And then these are actually original guides, although this is a protection plan. It's not for this car. For some reason, it's in here, but unless somebody just put the wrong pin down, but I don't think it's for this car. But for documentation, it's kind of cool. And then this is a real, authentic 1963 with the stamp and everything on it. Guy, this is a cool piece of history, man. So anyway, that's that, and I think that having some documentation is important. I think those little type tiny things like that make for the value to continue to go up. Sorry, I was just so enamored by this car. I'm reading it going, man, I'm thinking about how expensive was this car and why are there so few of them? And you know why there's so few, because it was so expensive and it was a lot of engine, man. Nobody had experienced 425 horsepower. The transmissions had to be ready for that kind of power. this really brought the horsepower race into existence. You know, we had 283 with dual quads in these Corvettes, you know, the 327 is coming out, the fuel injections and all those things were happening, but nobody got 425 horsepower again until 1966 when the 396 got put in the Corvette. So think about that. That's a lot of power. That's what makes these cars so valuable, because nothing else is out there like it. And we know the fact that this car started life as a red car, and the interior is black, all according to the cow tag that's on there. This has the QB code stamped on the block there. The dual quads that look to be just menacing. If we could find a way to have somebody make you a plexiglass air cleaner so you could see those. I would think about a Ferrari that has the clear cover there. So we need a 63 Impala. Anyway, sorry, I'm getting off track. The point of the matter is, this, my friends, is a wonderful driving car, but it is fast, it is powerful, it is rare, it is investment grade, and at the end of the day, it is a real deal SS409 four-speed super sport convertible. Here we are, circa 1963. I'm just taking my brand new Impala off the showroom floor. Just gonna start it up, see if it starts. Fires right up. Listen to the rumble. But what I love so much about it is the torque that this has. Watch when you rev it, what happens to the car. It rocks.